New drugs that might save or improve our lives are continually being discovered, but will they be safe or have any dangerous side effects? They're trialled on humans, so we can find out.
The trial we're currently conducting here at Richmond Pharmacology is for a drug in osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is a disease which makes the bone brittle and thin, and it can cause fractures. In actual fact, it's already being prescribed to patients at the moment in Europe, in many countries. And the reason we're doing another trial on this drug is that we want to check if it's got any effects on the heart. The study actually goes on over about 140 days, and the volunteers come 9 times to our clinic. Now, the reason for this is that they receive various treatments on the study, and so that we can see the effects of a placebo and of the actual study drug. A placebo is a dummy drug, and ideally it looks and it tastes the same as the real drug, so that no one knows, is it the real or is it the dummy drug? On this particular study, we are giving placebo as one of the treatments because it's very important for us to distinguish what are actual drug effects and what are not drug effects.
These people have volunteered to take part in a drugs trial. They're just one group of many. When they arrive, there's a strict admissions procedure.
On each admission, the volunteers will undergo an admission procedure, which is very similar to a hospital admission. We have to check that they're still healthy. We have to check that they're not pregnant. We have to check that they haven't taken any medication. That also includes drugs of abuse. We do an alcohol breath test. Because there's quite strict criteria the volunteers have to stick to, because all of them could potentially affect the clinical trial.
The volunteers stay overnight as trial day starts early. At 06:30, the trial begins. Before being given the drug, the volunteers have baseline checks, an ECG, which checks their heart rhythm, and blood tests.
It's a long day, we get up quite early, and it's very strict, the timing. We eat to the minute and have our doses and our blood taken and our blood pressure taken at specific times, so it's quite tough.
At 08:30, the first volunteer is given the medication. And at precisely timed intervals, the remaining volunteers are given their dose.
This has to be done very carefully, so that is usually done by a doctor and a pharmacist. We always check that the volunteer has correctly taken the medication, so we would check the mouth. Neither the doctors nor the volunteers know which treatment they are receiving. And it is packed in such a way that we cannot work it out. This is the best way of doing such a clinical trial, and it's called double blind.
From 0900, the volunteers start having their heart monitored using an ECG. For the next 4 hours, they will all have an ECG every half an hour. Everything is timed to the minute.
This particular study, it would take nearly 30,000 ECGs, of course over a few months, but it's a large number of things that need to be done, and the volunteers during that time have certain restrictions. For example, the food is standardized, the amount of water and the time when they can drink water is standardized.
All these constraints are extremely important. They help to make sure this is a fair test.
There's very many factors you should consider when you want to ensure that a drug trial is a fair test. You have to make sure that there is a benefit to doing the study in the first place. The second very important thing is that the study needs to be safe, and that we as investigators need to make sure a study is safe to the volunteers. The third factor, I think, in conducting a fair trial is to make sure you do the study properly. So you should make sure you know exactly what you do, and you should make sure you follow the protocol in all steps.
All drug trials have to follow a pre-agreed schedule. This is known as the protocol. After lunch, the trial slows down, but the volunteers are still monitored.
In the afternoon, you have a lot more free time to yourself to go to the internet room or TV room, just relax, read a book, read a paper, just, you know, really have more time to yourself.
The last factor to do a fair trial is to make sure you record the data completely and accurately. You don't withhold any information. You report the data as you have found it, no matter whether the result is to your liking or to the sponsor's liking or not.
All the data from the drug trial goes to a specialized area called data management. It takes months for each drug trial to be completed and the data analyzed, and every drug undertakes many trials before it can ever be prescribed.